completely destroy that high place that is in our life. And I'm going to tell you, like the word of God says in 2 Corinthians 10:4-5. I had to back up for a minute. God had me looking at verse 5, but he said back up and go to verse 4, because verse 4 lets you know something. The word of God says in 2 Corinthians 10:4, it says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Meaning we ain't fighting with Glocks, we ain't fighting with Uzis, we ain't fighting with M16s, we ain't fighting with battle axes. He said the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. He said, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. So the weapon that God gave you, it might not be able to knock down a natural wall, but I guarantee you it can break down some spiritual walls. It may not be able to knock down a natural barrier, but I guarantee you that weapon through God can tear down some spiritual barriers. It might not be able to knock down a natural stronghold, but I guarantee you spiritual strongholds, once you get the swing of that weapon, can't stand. Woo! Bless God. But then it goes on to say, to cast down every imagination, every high thing that seeks to exalt against itself, against the knowledge of God. So that weapon has been designed to tear down the high places in the spirit, those things that seek to exalt itself above God, those thoughts that seek to want to exalt itself above God, those desires that want to exalt themselves above God, those habits that want to exalt themselves above God. The word of God said to cast down every imagination. Don't leave one standing. If it tries to pop in, you better knock it down. If it tries to slip in, you better slip it right back out. God said every imagination. Every high thing that seeks to exalt itself above the knowledge of God and bring it to every captivity, every thought under the obedience of Christ. That's what the word of God said in 2 Corinthians 10:4-5. But my God, my God, my God. God said, I want you. The problem with us, and I'm almost done. The problem with us, the Spirit of God showed me. He told me, matter of fact, he said, the problem with you first. My God, my God. Because this word was dealing with me. I'm sorry, sis. This word was dealing with me. He said, the problem with you is that you have a tendency to do this. Is that we go in with the weapons of our warfare that are mighty through God to the pulling down our strongholds. And we'll knock the stronghold down. And as we knock the stronghold down, we leave pieces. Uh-huh. Oh, come on, Holy Ghost, come on. Come on, I feel like preaching this thing now. See, we leave pieces. And see, when the urge hits, for us to get, if the urge hits and that stronghold comes calling, what we'll do is, my God, we're trying our best not to be mad, but that urge to hit, that urge to be mad will hit us, and there's enough pieces left that we'll go back and begin to... And we'll build that stronghold back. So now when we're mad, I can stand in a place, in this high place, where God's not exalted, where I can do me, where I can take care of myself, and now I can be mad. If I don't want to forgive someone, I might have torn down unforgiveness, that stronghold of unforgiveness, but if the urge hits, and I want to look my sister or my brother that looked at me funny, then I'll go back over here. If I don't feel like forgiving them, I'll... And I'll build that sorrow. Now I ain't gotta forgive my brother. See, over there when I was doing God's thing, God would have said forgive him. But I don't feel like forgiving him right now. I wanna feel that, like I just wanna stay in this state of unforgiveness for a moment. And now that I've got enough pieces left, it may not be the way it was the first one, but I got just enough where I can wrestle and abide and sit there and stew in my unforgiveness.
All right.
But God said those days are over. I want you to take the approach of Josiah, and when you break that thing down in the spirit, I want you to grind that thing to powder. I don't want there to be a splinter left. I don't want there to be a block of wood left. I don't want there to be a brick left. I don't want any dust left. He said, my God, break it down to powder. So if that day comes when that urge hits and you're trying to go back and you're trying to rebuild, you don't have nothing to build with because there's nothing left. You don't have nothing but dust. You couldn't build it if you wanted to. You couldn't build this thing if you wanted to. Why? Because there's nothing left. God said, I want you to break it down so much that even when the earth comes calling, that you go to that place and there's nothing there. There's nothing there to be in. There's nothing there to build. There's nothing there to reside in. And God said, my God, and once you get to that place, my God, my God, my God, when you get to that place and you get to encourage myself. I've got no choice but to praise in spite of my circumstance. I ain't got nothing to go back to. I ain't got no choice but to do this the right way. I've got no choice but to do this the right way. And I want, oh my God, I wonder if the people of God, even in this house, can begin to get this thing in their spirit that as you now, as you've heard the words of the Lord, that if I'm going to do this, then from this point on, I'm going to do it the right way. That now I'm all the way in. That now, God, I'm going to give you all the glory out of my life. There's some high places I kept to myself, but today is the day that high place comes down and you get all the glory out of my life. You get all stronghold comes down. Today is the day where before in the past I might have knocked it down and left the pieces, but today is the day that I don't leave a single piece behind. My God, my God, the altar call is simple today. The altar call is simple. If somebody's saying yes, God has gotten the glory out of my life. There's a lot of areas where God is pleased with my life. There's some areas where I've given him the glory. But I know for myself, there's still one high place that I've been able to go back to when I wanted to step in my flesh, when I just wanted to be angry, when I just wanted to do my own thing. I still had a high place I could go to. But today is the day I want God to get all the glory out of my life. Today is the day I want to tear down that high place once and for all. If that's your prayer, I'm going to just ask you to come to the front. Just come on to the front.